Hi, hello, welcome to my channel. It's nothing special. I just have a light, so I'm just blinding myself right now. In this video, you'll probably see me like now and then tomorrow morning, because I only have a bit of time now. But I kind of wanted to start this video, so, you know, keeping it active. It's like a movie, you're gonna see me different outfits, looking differently. Not that it matters. Not that anybody cares. So I just wanted to clarify on that, because, yeah. I'll be looking different. I'm trying to like exhaust myself because I had too much caffeine today, and I really want to start on this topic because it's important. It's important for you to know. It's important to let your kids know. It's important to let your fucking. It's important to let people you go to class with. That should be called your classmates. Let everybody know. All in this together. This is fairly fresh, actually. The challenge slash game slash. Really, suicide mission that I'm talking about today has started in 2017. Since then, since they have found these culprits and have convicted a couple of people, this game actually exists on the dark web under a bunch of different names. Some of these different names are Silent House, The Sea of Whales, or Wake Me Up at 4:20 a.m., which sounds like a boy band name, but it's not. It's actually pretty grim. And it's speculated that the name came from this habit, well, from this concept of beaching, where the whales would be abandoned on beaches and then left to die. So you can kind of guess where this is going, but you have no idea, trust me. The story of the Blue Whale Challenge actually began on 22nd of November 2015, where the Russian girl Irina Palenkova was caught sticking up her middle finger to the camera, and it was apparent that this finger was covered in blood, and she posted it with the words NYA bye. And the next day she has taken her own life. This name originated in Russia and it has taken about 100 lives in Russia, but it has been popular all around the world. And usually people that are mostly targeted are between the ages of 12 and 19. So out of some people that they have arrested, there is one that is just special, like, there is one that is just a special kind of human. His name is Philip Budeikin. He has said to be doing this because he considered the people that actually follow through to be biological waste. So he has claimed that by doing this challenge and by, you know, leading people to eventually commit suicide, he was cleansing the society. Which is actually interesting because I really wanted to do this for a long time. But I've also been watching the last season of The Sinner. Kind of has this ideology of the Übermensch, which is famous for like heroes and kind of, you know, from Nazi history. But it's kind of the ideology that's really interesting, that you have the right to decide who lives, who dies. So Philip was 22 when he started posting about this game on the social forums and sort of like secret social media websites. And he deemed that this is righteous because he's cleansing the society by pushing people who have no value, according to him, to commit suicide. So, also because his charges are only that he was inciting the suicide of a minor, he only got 3 years in prison from like all of the sources that I could find, so please, if somebody has different type of information, now would be a good time to console my fucking soul and tell me he may have gotten more years than that. There have obviously been other humans, so there's this guy who was a postman, his name was Ilya Sidorov. He has managed to groom and convince 32 children to join this group and follow these commands. So yesterday we left it off and the police has actually charged 2 people who were behind the Blue Whale Challenge. In terms of how people actually got to participate in this challenge in the first place, you can't just actually apply somewhere or post on the socials or, you know, hashtag Blue Whale Challenge. Well, you can eventually, but not in the beginning. So these administrators would really groom these people. So they would target people on the socials who would post stuff on depression, things on suicide, etc. And then, you know, they would kind of like assess your mental health. And then they would invite you into this Blue Whale Challenge, which kind of sounded like a game. This is the main trick behind it. First of all, it has the word challenge in it, which, you know, it's kind of very, can go very viral, can go very popular on the internet. But then also they would present it as like deploying them as agents. So giving them like one task to complete, one assignment in a sense per day. And also the trick is once the victim, because they were really victims in this case, would accept this challenge, what would happen is that the administrator would infect their laptop and everything with viruses and with the malware. Well, they would actually make them believe that they have done so, and then if they don't comply with every single task, including the last one, they threatened to expose them to the whole family and friends and to expose like their darkest secrets, which in those cases, those people were really vulnerable. So it is usually to do with depression or suicide. Now to describe the tasks. So they would be given 50 tasks for 50 days that they participate in this challenge. So each day they're to complete a task, and always the final task is to commit suicide in some or other morbid way. Now the trick here is obviously it doesn't start as a threat, and it kind of starts with very easy tasks. In almost all of these cases, there's one which is like wake up at like 4:20 in the morning, hence why this challenge has been renamed 4:20 in the morning as well. Then it is watch horror movies every single morning, first thing when you wake up. And then with time, it kind of escalates to slowly starting to like cut yourself. So it is like make a small cut on your arm. There is a viral post online of people actually carving like a whole whale on their forearm as well. And then it's like posted on the internet. Every single time, it's not just when you cut yourself, but every single task you complete, you need to post online for curator's approval, and then they can approve you, and then the next day they send you another task. Now, let me just read out some of the most morbid tasks. So I kind of mentioned like cutting stuff with a razor. The more innocent ones are sort of like draw a whale on a sheet of paper, send a picture to the curator, wake up at 4:20 a.m. and go to the roof, the higher the better, so to like to mentally immediately like brainwash you and prepare you for jumping off the roof eventually. Now, it can start with like watching a movie that curator sends you in the morning, which is usually like some horror, really disturbing shit, but then it kind of escalates to watching psychedelic and horror movies the whole day. It's go to the roof, stand on the edge of the roof, go to the bridge, stand on the edge of the bridge. Then it's like, if you are already on the roof or on the bridge, sit on the edge and like have your legs dangling from the edge. Another one is wake up at 4:20 a.m. and go to the rails, like visit any railroad you can find. Again, it is specifically targeted to be this early in the morning, or you know, very first thing in the morning or very last thing at night, because that's when you're most vulnerable as well. As I mentioned, they control everything. So they control the content you consume. They sort of usually decide when you wake up in the morning, and it is usually 4:20. Any music that they send you, any movies that they send you, is all curated by them. It's never like your choice of what your task is for the day. So in terms of why I'm covering it, why it is super important, I kind of made a section like what parents and kids need to know. So the first pattern that you have picked up on probably is noticing whether your child or your teenager, usually the target group is between 12 and 19, so noticing whether they're suddenly waking up early in the morning every single day at a specific time for no reason, and then it just follows by, you know, suddenly watching, you know, like large amount of horror movies, listening to completely different type of music that they usually listen to, and then just kind of being like completely dozed off, zoned out during the day. Also, if they cover their arms like with long sleeves suddenly, and they have never done that before, suddenly, even though, you know, the weather can change, etc., if they're covering different cuts, or if you notice these different cuts as well on their body, it's not just about getting up at the exact same time. It's also the kind of isolate themselves from friends and family around that time. Their sleeping habits completely change, because obviously, they will want you to be sleep deprived in this challenge, because that's when like you can't actually think for yourself and you're just even more affected. So it's probably watch a horror movie first thing before bed, but like don't go to bed before midnight and then wake up at 4:20 a.m. and then you just had like no sleep, you're completely exhausted, and just it's very easy to brainwash you after 50 days of this. So if you're a parent out there or a teenager and somebody starts suddenly distancing themselves and just implementing all of these habits, it's kind of really important to notice them. I'm going to leave like a suicide helpline below as well for people to chat about this, but I just found this topic so interesting, because obviously among all of the other perverted shit that happens online, it's kind of one of those more fascinating ones, because people are getting more and more skilled into making it fun for teenagers, into making it as a challenge, into, you know, presenting this thing which is like, hey, I'm gonna recruit you as an agent, and everybody today who watches all these action movies, everything about, you know, FBI, CIA, everybody's like, oh my god, spies, agents, I want to be like one of them. And then it's very easy to actually convince those people, and it's usually the most vulnerable that are very easily convinced. So even though this kind of happened in 2017, it still kind of moves on through different names. Even though this particular challenge happened in 2017, it's important to raise awareness about similar things happening online and kind of make everybody aware, so the peers of those between the most vulnerable ages and their parents as well. But yeah, that's it from me today. I have nothing else to tell you, except from like, subscribe and click on that bell button. Mostly like and subscribe, okay? I don't really care about the bell button as much right now. Share it with your friends and family. Positive vibes only. Bye. Bye, guys.